You ever see a good drug story on the news? Never. News is supposed to be objective, isn't it? It's supposed to be
news.
But every drug story is negative.
Well, hold it. I've had some killer fucking times on drugs.
Let's hear the whole story.
Always that same LSD story you've all seen.
Young man on acid thought he could fly, jumped out of a building. What a tragedy.
Look at that. He's an idiot. He thought he could fly? Why didn't he take off the ground first? You don't see ducks lined up to catch elevators to fly south. They fly from the ground, you moron. Quit ruining it for everybody.
They lie about marijuana. Tell you pot smoking makes you unmotivated. Lie. You're high. You can do everything you normally do just as well. You just realize it's not worth fucking up.
Sure, I can get up at dawn, go to a job I hate that does not inspire me creatively whatsoever for the rest of my fucking life. Or I can wake up at noon and learn how to play the sitar.
To destroy the fucking arms. You know what I mean? We keep arming these little countries. We'd be going to blow the shit out of them. We're like the bullies of the world, you know? Bush sold 160 fighter jets to Korea, then 240 tanks to Kuwait, and then goes around making speeches why he should be commander-in-chief, because we still live in a dangerous world.
Thanks to you, you fucker! What are you doing? Last week, Kuwaitis had nothing but rocks. Been arming the fucking world, man.
I was just down in Dallas, Texas. You know, you could go down there and Dealey Plaza where Kennedy was assassinated.
Anyway, they have the window set up to look exactly like the window that day. And it's really accurate, you know? Because Oswald's not in it. Talking about Kennedy, people come up and they'll be talking about Kennedy, man. A long time ago.
I'm like, alright, then don't bring up Jesus to me.
Bible at some point. And oh, Jesus and the disciples walked to Nazareth, but the trail was blocked by a giant brontosaurus with a splinter in his paw. Oh, the disciples did run a shrieking, "What a big fucking lizard, Lord!" But Jesus was unafraid, and he took the splinter from the brontosaurus' paw, and the big lizard became his friend. And Jesus sent him to Scotland, where he lived in a loft for oh so many years, inviting thousands of American tourists to bring their fat fucking families and their fat dollar bills. And oh, Scotland did praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.